Oh yeah, here we go. Come on. Get in. Get in.
Today's video is brought to you by GameGlass. GameGlass allows you to take control of your ship from a tablet or phone. Not only that, but you also get on-screen information about your ship, your targets, and the world around you. So gone are the days where you have no more room for your key bindings, or you have to alt-tab out of the game to look up market data. On top of that, GameGlass also works with Star Citizens, so follow the link in the video description and try GameGlass for free. If you like it and want more shards and features, you can buy them individually, or you can subscribe to GlassPass. Use offer code DTEA on checkout and get 5% off your first purchase.
Oh, there we go. Waterworld. Two Waterworlds, it seems. High metal content. High metal. This one could be interesting. We can land and it has another body. If they are close enough to each other, this could be a pretty sight there. Oh, we got lava spouses here. Oh, that could be cool. And vents. Lava spouses and vents. Gonna set it down on the far side of these mountains here. If I did my predictions right, we should have a very good view. We can just see the planet there. Let's see if we can find some lava spouse things. Okay, we're 12 kilometers up, that's fine. Okay, so that light area there was a very light blue color. Let's try to dive into that area then. Yeah, but if we were flying too fast for them not to render, then we should be seeing them now. What is that? Looks like a little dust cloud or something. Is it just me, or does that look like a dust cloud to you as well? Oh, look, it's actually moving. It's not static. Dust cloud confirmed. It's a little dust devil. Is the temperature changed inside it? No. I don't believe it's scannable. It's not really a targetable object. No, it dissipated. No, it's gone. Oh, see, there's another one. Oh, that is cool. They're not very violent. Since I remember you complaining of... Jesus, Crunchier. Did it do a better job with this one? Yeah, this one is better. I like those rock formations. Yeah, but there's no lava. I feel cheated. Game told me there would be lava. There's no lava. But the view up here is pretty. I'm gonna drop down in that area there because I don't know why it dropped me out here. But that looks interesting. Look at all the like that spiky area there. You can see how the texture's loading in. Textures, it's the... Oh, there we go, there's something there. Hello. I think those were the vents. There were also vents on the surface here. Oh, look at that. Look at the temperatures at the top of the screen there. It's 547 Kelvin. But as I walk over and I step onto that... Again, it's floating, which is a bit of a shame. But that's definitely one of them. And there's another floating one here. Are those hot as well? Can we scan these? What do we have here? Oh, there we go. See, now this is more like it. Look at the temperatures here. This is a very nice one. So walking away, and we are back to the 512, because we are in the shadow.
580. Warning. Suit thermal limit exceeded.
Uh-oh. You can also feel the planet is getting warmer. When we started, daylight was like 540 something, but it seems like the sun is coming up, so it's getting warmer. Let me actually first show you. Let's look at this. Zoom in on the planets. So you can see the two little stars there on the side. And when you zoom in, you can actually see how quickly the planet is moving in the sky. See, now there's only one star there, and there's another one that's about to be covered. It's halfway gone now. 4K tap, no, 4K utility is not running at the moment. I'll try to explain what I think is going on here. If you have a hillside and it starts out very low poly, right? So you start out with something that may look like this, right? This is your geometric shape. And then it says, okay, I need to place a geyser somewhere. And it says, fine, I'm going to place a geyser. I'm going to place the geyser like that. Okay, that looks fine. The sides are now covered. They're underneath the ground. That's perfect. But now as you come in and I walk closer, it loads the higher geometric shape. So these lines here are going to get shorter, but more detailed. I guess you get my point here, right? And because of that, the ground is actually being lowered. And now, all of a sudden, where before we wouldn't be able to see, we could only see down to the edge, and it was probably fine when they placed it. But now we could all of a sudden see the underside of it, which we are not supposed to. And then we can look up into it. I think it's something like that that's going on. This is my guess, at least. And then you can see more floaty rocks here. Oh, you see? There. Those were updated. Did you see that? Those were actually updated as the terrain got loaded in. And I think the problem is, you see, as the texture is loading in here, the altitude of these are not changed. got myself a little barbecue here. Yeah. Yeah, this is fine. That planet is getting awfully big in the sky now. Oh, look at that one over there. This one looks like the top has been blown off. Oh, look at that. There is a geyser down there. Ah! I want to find a way to get in there. It must be doable. Okay, I think we're going to try to get an SRV, because SRVs can bait that. The SRVs are like horses in Skyrim. They can just run up vertical walls. So I think our best bet to get up there is with an SRV. I need to find a place to put this thing down first, though. They're so close. So I think the distance from there to there is shorter than that distance there. But we need to come from out here and then kind of drive at an angle to get over the edge there. Because if we just drive straight up, we're going to end up with that one. I don't know. How does this look? That looks more promising to me. Let's go. Let's do this. Climbing inside a volcano. Here we go. Oh yeah, here we go. Come on. Get in. Get in. Get in! Yes! Woohoo! I'm claiming that I have now I've now crawled into a volcano. Oh, this might have been a bad idea. Maybe I can stick the landing over here on the other side. If I'm really, really good. I can. I need to do this in third person. Because I can't see when I'm coming over the ridge. And if I overshoot just the slightest, that's what's waiting for me on the other side. A very, very steep drop and a volcano at the bottom. Let's try this again with more speed. No! There we go! That was what I was trying to avoid. I overshot it. But I stick the landing. That's fine. Yeah, safe landing. We could go for another run if we wanted to. I think I will name this volcano Astro's Inferno. That's what we're gonna call it from now on.